Change your editor to Asset Browser. There you have to add your data blocks like object collections, geometry, shaders and more. For example, select an object, enter the shading properties, do a right click on a material and select Mark Asset. You successfully added this data block to your asset library. As a YouTuber, I need to say, please don't like this video, and please, by all Blender gods, don't subscribe to this YouTube channel for further videos. Sorry for this joke. I know it's annoying when you hear the like and subscribe phrase every single video again and again, but yeah, it is actually important for every channel, and it is important for me as well. 94% of my viewers haven't subscribed yet, and they're wondering why. So I just want to know right now, if you are a viewer or a subscriber. Let me know this in the comments below, so that I get a statistic with this video. Thank you very much for this. Let's start with the tutorial now. Blender 2.9 Alpha includes a new editor, the Asset Browser, which main use case is to create local user asset libraries. You are able to store data blocks for your own reuse in self-defined locations on the hard drive and conveniently access them from any project. In my opinion, this is similar to any game engine software like Unity, where you are able to create a prefab or asset. This video will handle how to manage basic listing and browsing for Blender data blocks saved locally. The Asset Browser is a new feature of Blender 2.9.2 and is currently under development. This browser is categorized as an editor type and can be selected for any workspace panel. You find the Asset Browser on the very right side of this menu listed as a data editor. When you click through the categories like scene, animations, object and collections, and so on, then you maybe ask yourself why everything is empty. The Asset Browser is not a tool which is scanning the file for possible assets. No, it is a tool which allows you to create and control your custom library, which may be useful for this file or other files as well. So you need to fill it. For this, I will enter the shading tab in the Asset Browser, select an object in my scene, which already have a material or a shader applied, and enter the material properties. Now do a right click on your wanted material and select Mark Asset. The material will be added to the Asset Browser in the shading tab here. Now you are able to just grab this material and drag it to other objects in your scene. So far this is only working in object mode, and you are not able to do this in edit mode with specific selected faces. Add as many materials as needed. Very important and useful adjustments are refresh, rename and delete, which can be found by right-clicking a specific material in asset window. The same theory is working with object or collections, but this time it is a little bit more hidden to find this. Go to the outliner and do a right click on your wanted object or collection. Head to ID data and there you find Mark Asset. I'm not sure if this is like this because the feature is not finished so far, but I got best results with objects which don't have a material assigned so far. For example, I was not able to place the axe with the assigned axe material and pull a material from the asset window on it. Somehow the material doesn't replace the old material, but it works fine when your 3D asset don't have any materials assigned by default. So the theory is clear how to add specific data blocks in the asset browser, isn't it? When you created this asset library, then this works only for this specific file. It will be not transferred to your next planned file by default. But you are able to do this very easily. Open any file and enter the preferences. There you have to select the File Path tab and head to the Asset Libraries category. Create a new slot and enter a proper name together with the file path. This is all. Now you are able to just call up the asset browser and switch here from current file to the needed library. So you get the marked assets immediately. It is possible to create specific asset libraries in specific files and switch later very easily to your needed library. I think this is so useful for any kind of project. So far, it is a little bit tricky when you change anything to your data block. The asset library isn't updating every single change of a material even though you save the file. I was only able to delete the asset itself and add it again afterwards. If you change anything on your source file and update your library, then this doesn't mean that all objects in other files will update too. Just the library will be updated, not the placed objects or materials. That's all so far. I'm looking forward to Blender 2.9 too and its official publish date. I don't need to say anything for this outro because I already made this great intro. Cheers!